COCOM model KCV801 installation and demonstration. First, you start by opening the boxes, the box of the monitor, which you will find the manual for you to consult, the handset, the connectors, and all peripherals needed for the installation. Behind the monitor, you will find the bracket, which you are going to use to hang the monitor on, the power lead to connect to the power, and all connectors to connect. After you take off the camera from the box, you check there is all connectors and screws. And prepare for the installation. You have to start bypassing the cable. You have to use an RJ45 UTP cable for this kind of installation. You have to pass the wire from the camera to the monitor. If you have additional monitors, you are going to use the same cable from a monitor to another, or from the monitor to another handset. It depends on the system. After passing the wire, you start by installing the bracket. Check the height of the monitor, drill the holes, put the screws on the wall and tighten them to the bracket on the wall. After tightening all the screws, you have to cut the cable coming from the camera to the monitor. Make sure the cable is long enough for the connection to the wires of the connector. Trim all cables. You are going to use 4 wires for the system and 2 wires for the lock. Now you have to connect the blue of connector to 1 of camera, yellow of connector to 2 of camera, red of connector to 3 of camera, white of connector to 4 of camera. SW1 and SW2, you have to use them for the lock. If you have additional monitors or handsets, you have to use the other connector in parallel, one to another. After, put some tape or shrinking sleeve to cover the wires and make sure they are not shorted. Connect the tape on the wires one by one or shrinking sleeve. After you finished from the connection, put the wire in the hole back to place. After, take the monitor and start by connecting the connector to camera 1 as described in the diagram. You have the diagram with all connectors in the picture at the back side of the monitor. You can see connector 1, connector 2, 3 and 4. And the SW1 and SW2 are the screw for the lock. You connect the connector and SW1 and SW2 for the lock. You hang the monitor to the bracket. First, pass the cable of the power to the nearest point or socket outlet. After you have the monitor positioned on the wall, you have the screw provided in the box, and there is a small hole in the middle underneath the monitor. You have to tighten the screw to the monitor. Take the handset after connect the connector at the left bottom side in the small connector hole and hang the handset to the monitor, and the installation of the monitor is ready. Now we are going to connect the camera. You can use different types of cameras on this kind of monitor. First, you take the bracket of the camera and the nameplate. You have the screw, which you are going to unscrew. And we have the bracket of the camera. We check the positioning, we make sure we make it eye level for best viewing. You drill the hose and put the screws to the camera on the wall and tighten them with the screwdriver. After tightened all screws, you have to cut the cable. Make sure you cut long enough to put the connection to the camera. Trim all cables one by one. We are going to use 4 cables and 2 other cables for the lock. After trimming all the cables, you get the camera and you start by connecting the wires. You are going to connect 1 to blue of connector of monitor, 2 to yellow of connector of monitor, 3 to red of connector of monitor, 4 to white of connector of monitor, number 5 and number 6 are used as a lock switch. Number 5 and number 6 are used for a lock, but it is better to use it from the monitor. After you put the camera in place in the bracket, you bring the screw provided in the box and you tighten it to the bracket on the camera. After you get the nameplate and you put it in place in the fitting, and the camera and the system is ready. COCOM demonstration model KCV801 color monitor. The visitor comes, rings the bell. The attendant can answer from the handset and can open the door from the right bottom button. Functions. The first button from the left is used for camera 1 observation. Second button is used for camera 2. Third button is used for internal communication. And fourth button is used for the lock. The middle button is used for the menu and the scrolling is up and down, left and right. You have the switch, the power switch at the bottom side. And you have also the volume controls exactly under the handset.